This video provides instructions for filtering stream or river water for the Huron River Watershed Council's Chemistry and Flow Monitoring Program. Filtering a sample allows our laboratory partners to analyze chemicals dissolved in the water column. You can perform this procedure while in the stream or along the side of the stream. For this procedure, you will need a caulk gun, a 50 or 60 ml syringe, a syringe filter, a bottle to collect the filtered water, and a water sample to filter. First, we want to rinse our syringe with sample water. You can either use the water from the 1 liter bottle that you collected, or if you're in stream, pulling water directly from the stream. You'll pull at least 5 milliliters of water into the syringe and swirl it around to clean the inside, and expel the water either on the ground, to the side, or downstream. Rinse the syringe 3 times and then fill the syringe full with sample to the 50 or 60 milliliter mark on the syringe. Take care not to get air into the syringe. Now attach a new syringe filter to the syringe and try not to touch the tip of either the syringe or filter. Then rinse the filter by pushing 3 to 5 milliliters through the filter. Next, secure the syringe into the caulk gun by holding the release plate and pulling back the rod. Align the two plungers and nest the tip of the syringe into the opening of the caulk gun. Finally, filter the water by squeezing the handle of the caulk gun and dispensing the filtered water into the provided bottle. At this point, you will only have enough water to fill the bottle half full. You will need to repeat steps 2, 3, 5, and 6 until the bottle is full or has at least 100 milliliters in it. As a reminder, those steps are to fill the syringe with sample only after you have taken off the filter, then reattach the syringe filter, and then re-secure the syringe into the caulk gun. Finally, squeeze the handle to dispense the remainder of the filtered water into the bottle until it is full. Cap the bottle and put it in the cooler for delivery to the lab. Pause here if you'd like to review the steps of the procedure. A few final tips before you conduct this procedure. One, the procedure can be performed while you are in the stream, stream side, or back at your vehicle using the 1 liter of water you've already collected. You can reuse the syringe between sites, taking care to rinse it at least 3 times with sample water to prevent contamination between sites. Avoid touching the tip of the syringe or filter with your hand, because your hand may have some things that could contaminate the sample. And lastly, do not pull water into the syringe while the filter is attached. Make sure to remove the filter before pulling up more water, and reattach it afterwards. Thank you for volunteering with the Huron River Watershed Council's Chemistry and Flow Monitoring Program and for taking the time to learn this procedure.